After discovering the functionality of diodes and bipolar junction transistors, the next devices being calculated by the simulation software are JFETs. JFET means junction field effect transistor. The transistor shown here consists of an n-doped crystal with the source pin connected at the left and the drain connected at the right side. At the middle of the crystal you can see the p-doped area with the gate pin. The software is calculating the procedures inside a single layer of silicon atoms. The crystal is considered to be symmetrically, hence the effects of the layers above and below the calculated layer are negligible. The layer could be the cross-sectional area of a cylinder or a cuboid. In the first case, the p-doped area of the gate would be circular, in the second case it would consist of an upper and a lower cuboid, which would both be connected to one gate pin. The transistor shown here is 100 atoms wide and 122 atoms high, hence the dimensions are 89 to 47 nanometers. There are 204 pentavalent impurity atoms inside the n-doped area and 153 trivalent impurity atoms inside the p-doped gate area. Hence, there are 204 extra electrons and 153 holes inside of the layer of the crystal lattice. Once again, the concentration of impurity atoms is significantly higher than inside of real devices to be able to visualize the processes. Like at the simulation of diodes and bipolar junction transistors, only a few postulations are sufficient to calculate the virtual JFET. Initially, the Java program calculates the electrostatic forces of all charges inside the crystal layer acting on the current particle. A force with a random direction and an absolute value between 0 and x is added to the sum of the electrostatic forces. Those random component represents the thermal energy of the charged particles according to the adjusted temperature. The charge is moving to those nearby atom which is closest to the angle of the resulting force. To keep the calculation power low, the holes are considered to be positively charged particles moving freely around the crystal layer. If you have watched the previous videos of this series, you should already know that those movement of the holes is caused by the swap of electrons between atoms of the crystal. The movement of the holes is slowed down by inserting randomized breaks between two steps. To facilitate the migration of the movable charges away from the fixed charges of the impurity ions, the attracting force inside of a small radius around the particles is reduced by the software. Let's start the simulation without any voltage attached to the pins. There are two p-n junctions inside of the crystal layer, acting like those inside of a diode, which was treated very detailed at one of the previous videos. Initially, the electrons and holes are moving randomly through the crystal. If an electron and a hole are side by side, both charges vanish during a recombination process, forming a neutral atomic bond. Two movable charges are removed from the crystal, leaving two different charged fixed ions behind. Thereby, the negatively charged impurity atoms are located inside of the p-doped gate area, while the positively charged ions are located inside of the n-doped area of the crystal. Electric fields are created between those areas of the crystal. Those fields inhibit the swap of charges between the variably doped areas of the transistor, hence an equilibrium is established after some time has passed by and we can't see any further recombination processes. Let's stop the simulation and have a closer look at the distribution of charges at the zones of the crystal. The number of freely moving charges decreased to 128 electrons and 77 holes. 76 electron hole pairs vanished by recombination processes. All of the holes are located inside of the p-doped area, while the electrons are inside of the n-doped area of the transistor. In sum, the gate area is 68 times negatively charged, while the n-doped area is accordingly 68 times positively charged. The total charge of the whole crystal is still zero. While having a closer look at the outer respectively inner areas of the p-doped gate, you will recognize that the outer areas are more negatively charged than the core areas. Likewise, the n-doped zones around the gate are more positively charged than those located at the edges of the transistor. As you could see at the video about semiconductor diodes, electric fields are caused by those heterogeneous distribution of charges, keeping the movable charges away from particular areas. Electrons are pulled away from the junction into the n-doped region, holes into the p-doped regions. Because of the strength of the electric fields, there are no movable charges around the junction. Same as inside a diode, a depletion layer is established around the two junctions. What is happening if a voltage is attached to the source respectively drain pin? Inside of the virtual crystal, the voltage source causes a disequilibrium of charges near the zones of the terminals. A positive voltage drop between source and drain leads to an injection of electrons at the left side, while the same number of electrons is removed at the right side of the transistor. The total charge of the crystal is still zero and the number of moving charges stays on a constant level. The zone at the source terminal gets more negatively charged, while those at the drain gets more positively charged. Those unbalanced distribution of charges pulls electrons to the drain terminal at the right side. An electric current is running through the transistor even if no voltage is applied to the gate pin. While having a closer look at the depletion layer, you will recognize that those area changed slightly after attaching the voltage to the transistor. Because of the fact that electrons are pulled to the right of the crystal, the holes are moving slightly to the left. The depletion layer gets weakened at the left side, while it is getting stronger at the right side. The zone being free of movable charges is no longer symmetrically arranged around the junction. For a short span of time, the left side is weakened in such a way that some more holes can recombine with electrons, forming more neutral atomic bonds. Hence, the p-doped region gets more negatively charged, while the n-doped region gets more positively charged. The depletion layer gets enforced and a further swap of movable charges is inhibited. Inside the n-doped region, the electrons are moving through a small channel between the two p-doped regions of the crystal. This is why the device shown here is called N-channel JFET. In contrast to the bipolar junction transistors treated at the previous video, JFETs are conductive without a voltage being applied to the gate pin. Hence, JFETs are called self-conducting, bipolar junction transistors are called self-locking. How can we modulate the flow of electrons with the help of the gate pin? The transistor is already conductive without a voltage attached to the gate, hence there must be a way to inhibit the flow of a current through the device. Let's have a look at the crystal at a state of equilibrium without any voltage attached to the pins. Like mentioned before, only a few electrons are located inside of the channel between the two p-doped regions. By enlarging the depletion layer, those electrons can be pushed away from the channel. The simulation of semiconductor diodes explained that the depletion layer grows whenever a p-n junction gets reverse biased. To do so, the p-doped region has to be attached to the positive terminal of a DC voltage source, while the n-doped region has to be attached to the negative terminal. So let's connect source and drain to a voltage source with such a polarity. The simulation software removes electrons at the source pin while they are injected at the gate pin. Near the gate pin, one hole vanishes during a recombination process whenever an electron is injected. The crystal is still neutral in sum, but the number of freely moving charges gets reduced. Inside of the p-doped regions, the number of holes is reduced, while the number of negatively charged impurity ions is kept constant. Hence, those areas get more negatively charged. Vice versa, inside of the n-doped region, the number of electrons gets reduced, while the number of positively charged impurity atoms is kept constant. Those areas get more positively charged. The holes inside of the crystal are pushed into the inner areas of the p-doped regions, the electrons into the core areas of the n-doped region. As you can see, the depletion layer around the junction is growing and the electrons are pushed away from the channel. Another thing you might have recognized is the fact that there are more electrons at the right side than at the left side of the crystal after attaching the voltage to the transistor. The drain is not connected to the voltage source, hence the disequilibrium is preserved over time. If this would be a real transistor inside of an electric circuit, those differences in potential would be balanced by an electric current running from drain to source. After pressing a button, the simulation software starts balancing the charges. Electrons are swept between the source and drain terminal until both halves of the crystal are equally charged, by what the depletion layer gets symmetrically shaped. The channel between the two p-doped regions is now 17 times positively charged, but those positive charge is more than just counterbalanced by the negative charges of the impurity ions above and below the channel. Furthermore, the positive charge of the neighboring zones is attracting negatively charged particles. Hence, electrons are pulled out of the channel. Let's connect the source and drain pin to the voltage source again. Note the correct polarity of the two voltage sources. There is a positive voltage drop between the source and drain pin and a negative voltage drop between the source and gate pin. The common terminal of the two voltage sources is the transistor's source pin. Once again, electrons are injected into the crystal at the source terminal and removed at the drain terminal, by what a disequilibrium of charges is established. In comparison to the right half of the crystal, there are 18 additional electrons at the left half. The thereby generated electric field is weakening the depletion layer at the left side, but even though, it is not strong enough to push electrons into the channel between the two p-doped regions, hence no current is running from the source to the drain terminal. The transistor is turned off. By attaching a negative voltage to the gate terminal, the current running through an n-channel JFET can be lowered, respectively stopped. While the negative voltage at the gate pin is lowered, electrons start drifting through the transistor as soon as a certain voltage level is reached. As you can see, a current is running through the gate terminal only for a short span of time, while the voltage drop at the gate is altered. As soon as an equilibrium is established, there is no exchange of mobile charges between the p-doped region of the gate and the n-doped region of the crystal. You can't observe recombination processes. In contrast to a bipolar junction transistor, no energy is consumed at the gate terminal to keep up those state of equilibrium. It is the electrostatic field of the depletion layer around the junction which affects the resistance of the transistor's source drain line, which is why this device is called junction field effect transistor. If the body material of the transistor consists of a p-doped crystal with two n-doped gate regions, the device is called p-channel JFET. Now, a positive voltage drop has to be attached between source and gate to enlarge the depletion layer and so to cut off the current running through the device. Because of the lower mobility of the holes in comparison to those of the electrons, the depletion layer is rising deeper into the p-doped region, which is why the channel has to be enlarged to make the transistor conductive without a voltage being attached to the gate. At the simulation shown here, the electrons are moving from the right to the left side of the transistor, hence the holes are moving from the left to the right through the device. You can download the source code of the Java program and get some more information about JFETs and other semiconductor devices at the project page. Thanks for watching and bye for now.